Hi friends, this is Anand here, and today I like to discuss about filmmaking for beginners. Filmmaking, as you are aware, is now an easy thing to do, especially even with a small camera or a DSLR you can do it. But I would advise you to have a DSLR with a 18 to 55 millimeter lens and also 200 millimeter lens minimum to start with. It costs around 30,000 to 35,000 rupees. This is the minimum investment which you have to make. So the basic thing in filmmaking is like the first step. Different people have different idea. For me is that the first thing you need to know is about the camera. Without a camera, you cannot make film. So even if you use a cameraman, you should know the limitations of a camera, because the camera is a mechanical eye. The basic mistake which newcomers or the people, students, school students, college students or working professionals make is like they make a story through their eye. So the camera is a mechanical eye. So what you see through the eye is different. So normally they say that what you see through your eyes is something like a 35 millimeter lens. So filmmaking is like telling a story, not through your eyes but through the camera. So you need to know about the functions of a camera and how a film is being made. For example, I can quote you two scenes. Like you're taking your camera on a wide shot. The subject is you're showing as if the subject is 100 feet away, and you try to show to the audience that the subject is actually crying. For example, it is crying or smiling or staring. If you show the subject which is 100 feet away, how do you think you will be able to show to the your audience that the person actually crying? So you need to make a close-up shot to establish that your subject is actually crying. So maybe initially to establish that the scene is happening in a park or a subway or in a hotel, you can have a long shot. But when the emotion takes place, you have to actually show it closer, so that the smallest activities, smallest nuances of filmmaking can be exploited to the maximum. So similarly, if you are showing a close-up shot of a subject who is running, for example, if it is a thief who is snatching a chain from a woman and running away, if you try to show a close-up shot or a shot which is following the person, you may never know what this person is doing. So instead, you have to cover both the subject, for example, the woman and also the thief. So you need to have a wide range shot which actually shows the thief running with his hand in action, with his leg moving. So you need to have a full shot wherein, or a pan shot where you can show all these characters together, okay, to exploit some more emotions like the staring of the woman or the shouting of the woman. Then again you have to go to the close-up shot. So then in the process of editing, you mix all these things to show, and the scene looks very reasonable and believable. So this is the first technique in filmmaking you need to understand. So being a beginner, you don't have the you don't have the fancy of using a costly camera or a steady cam or a helicam shot to show. So make your story very simple, okay? If you are talented, you don't need much of money. All you need is a basic camera and understand its limitation and build a story within that limitations. And also use basic lights, okay? Don't think of a big bomb blast scene or a chasing scene or a car chase scene. So try to keep the subjects minimal, like one or two characters or three characters you can keep. So if you have a multiple characters, like 5 to 10 people, and try to establish this shot, so you are not going to make up on your first try. So the point is, don't make multiple characters. So when you have a lot of characters, then again it is difficult to establish, because you have to show one subject talking to other, then why the others are listening, you have to show their emotion. So to start with, you can even start with a camera, a tripod, and you can start even with an interview, okay? And you can have different aspects of it. Something like I'm doing with a collar mic, a tripod, and a basic camera, Sony Alpha DSLR 58 is what I use, and also a basic lighting setup. Here I'm using a 1000 watt light with an umbrella, And also here, the side I have a tungsten filament lamp which is almost 40 to show a little bit of lighting in this side. So these are the basic things which you can start with. And once you develop, you can establish yourself. The basic thing what I want to communicate is, as a filmmaker, basic thing what you need to know is have a clarity of thought. So you are, as a director, as the captain of the ship. So you have to have an idea which is very clear so that you can make understand your team, lighting team or a cameraman and other people, assistant director, understand what you try to communicate. So make things very simple and try yourself. Hope this video will be useful for you. And mainly your scenes, it's like scene is like a combination of shots. Like what I say, is a close-up shot and a long shot and the establishing shot, you mix together, and in the editing process you have a short film. Basically try to do online, on the spot recording, so that you don't have to go for dubbing. So you have a shotgun mic, you can actually record the sound on the spot of the two subjects, which are two characters who are speaking, so that makes easier for you, so you don't have to worry about going into the editing studio and again have to dub the voice. So these are certain simple tips which I like to give for beginners, college students. Hope this will be useful for you. I'm waiting for your comments. So that is always good to discuss something which you have learned, so that I can also start learning more. So thank you very much for watching this video. Hope this will be useful for you, and I'll be coming with more videos and things which I learned to share with you, and on the process also learn myself, because I'm sitting alone here, mostly tied up with my work and normal routine work. Thank you for watching it patiently. Take care. Bye bye.